What Christ does not do is not God's sovereignty. Children who die carelessly, God is not involved. Disasters, God is not involved. Calamities, God is not involved. Evil, God is not involved. Sickness, no way. God is not involved. Why? Jesus healed the sick. Why? Jesus rebuked the storm. He rebuked the tsunami. Why? He raised the dead. Why? He restored people that were broken. Why? He gave life to the prostitute who came weeping at his feet. He gave her the gift of acceptance. He didn't treat her, you know, funny. He received her even before she told him what she came for. He didn't wait for her to tell him what she came for. He gave her the gift of acceptance. That's the sovereignty of God. For God so loved the world. Outside that, you can't find God. So God does not do what he wants to do outside Christ. Never. He only does what he wants to do in Christ. God was in Christ. God was in Christ. And what was the action? Reconciling. The sovereignty of God. You know, it is when these subjects like this are not well handled by the church that unbelievers don't get attracted to our God. You hear them say, how can you tell me God is a good God when he allows little children to die? Because they do not understand that the sovereignty of God is not just sovereignty. It is sovereignty that is controlled within a person called Christ. So Jesus is the explanation of all things. That's what we read. He is come to give us an understanding. Can somebody shout hallelujah?